hello, 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 and this fiery, hang on, I'm going to sit down. It's a fiery welcome here to Australia's brain freeze. That's right, the work of Andrew Scholl's Coldest 100. We look at a few of those, hang on a minute. The Coldest 100, Andrew Scholl put together there, and as you can see, I'm doing it all on my own today, so that's right. Welcome from Melissa there, and of course, Magpie TV, which will be a feature of the show. In fact, if you don't know what's going on here, you can have a look there. You can have a look there, whichever you like there. And the bubbles will be floating around as well. Sponsored today by Shapes, with the controversial piece of Tasmania, which we'll be getting to a little bit later. One of our big sponsors, of course, the 1985 summer edition of Dolly magazine. And guess what, people? Hats are back. That's right, and hats are back because mullets on women are back as well. All of that also in the show will be sponsored by TV Hits, the magazine you get when you can't find smash hits. And of course, Australasia, oh, hang on, hide the kids' faces. Hide their faces. Probably just a good, just hide their faces generally. But look at this. Australasian Post from May the 5th, 1955. We've got Leah McCartney from Melbourne on the front there, modelling the latest nightie that's all the rage. In fact, I'm sure you're probably all wearing her nightie right now, the second hand. Anyway, what have we got up first? Oh, Magpie TV. Thanks to Rob Darby and Ballarat for sending in photos of the magpies and a few neighbours around my place as well for doing that. I'd like to congratulate the primary school of Medlow Bath for designing my set for me from a drawing I sent them. Spot on. Well done, kids. But first, the Wiggles. That's right. I'm working with Paul Field now on the Sounds of Countdown show, which you can catch all around New South Wales at various times. But right now, have a look at him. Well, him and me work well together. Look at this. That is entertainment, people. Forget about Wake Up Jeff. Let's go Portuguese, folks. A quarter panda. Tasmania, it's cold. Everyone loves it there, it's fantastic, and you can have an apple. But enough about Tasmania. Let's talk about someone behind us here. Look at this, look at this. That's right, it's time to talk about the Crocker Barry and introduce our first guest to introduce Barry in just a moment. But Maynard, have you got many Barry Crocker albums? Well, there's this one, Barry Crocker on Broadway, signed by someone else. Barry Crocker's golden hits, there he is relaxing at home, and there he is doing a bit of gardening, digging up a bit of onion weed there, Barry is, good on you. There's Barry winning the snooker championship, and there he is with a native dingo winning the widest pants at the bottom competition in Barrowall in, I think, 1972. Well done there, Barry. Also, both sides of Barry, look at his car, and when he actually got inside his car, his head was in the boot on you, Crocker Barry, look at that. And of course he was Baz and McKenzie, so if you want to get drunk with him and eat a pie and wear a hat, he is the guy for you. And Barry Crocker, often, look, of course, if you lose your copy of Barry Crocker Sings For You, what will happen? It's okay, because I've got a second copy. Look at that. He does The Impossible Dream 18 times on this album. Barry Crocker, check out his YouTube channel. He's on X. He's on everywhere. Barry Crocker in London. There he is, and there he is at addressing the House of Commons, I believe. He was, because Barry was actually the Prime Minister for Australia for 6 months, I think, in the 80s sometime. Oh, Barry Crocker with a light, because he can do his own lighting. You think, that's not a bad shot of Barry, but when you open the gatefold, ra-da-da, ta-da-da-da, Barry Crocker, Volume 2. I don't know what was in the middle of Volume 1, but this song that's about to be introduced for you becomes off this album. Barry Crocker's Sound of Music, a great album. Look at that cast. You'd think it was a young talent time at first, but no, that was from his show Sound of Music. I think he took it over from Bobby Lynn. Now it's time to introduce an Australian legend, a man I've worked with many times and am humbled to be in his very presence. We asked him from his tower of arrogance to introduce Barry and introduce this clip. It's mind expanding, it's mind blowing, it's Mr. Tim Ferguson, living legend, Aussie.
Thanks, Maynard. You know, Barry Crocker is a legend. We all know Barry Crocker's a legend. I mean, the man won 5 gold Logies. That means he got the best one 5 times in a row. And the hair. One of the best things he ever did was this clip you're about to watch from 1969. Settle back, drink a martini, and enjoy Mr. Barry Hugh Crocker from 1969.
Hi, Maynard. Greetings from the Art Bunker. I'll be in your neck of the woods real soon, working on a new record. And I just wanted to give a big shout out to you and everyone watching Brain Freeze, Australia's Coldest 100 2024.
I've tried most other lemonades and I couldn't find one that I liked, so I made my own, and naturally I've called it Graham Kennedy's Blankety Blanks Lemonade. My baby. That'd put lead in your blanket, and I've decided to offer you, as an introductory bonus in various stores, this 500ml can at the 370ml can price. Now, that's a third more. Free! So go and buy my Blankety Blanks Lemonade. It's great. It really, really...
And thank you, Brigitte Handley, all the way from Germany. And by the way, just like Auntie Jack, Brigitte herself has got herself a picture disc. Auntie Jack, Brigitte Handley. Coming back to Australia to do some more recording. Thank you for being on the show. All the people on the show here were coerced against their will, but thank you for being on here anyway. Oh, by the way, in the background there, we've got Colette, The Reels, Blur Lives, and on the inside of The Reels' Neighbours album, look at that, a very cheeky, happy-go-lucky picture of Dave Mason. And on the back, that could be him wearing glasses or someone in his family. I think it's a trick, you know, when you put on glasses, you look up, who's that guy? Suddenly on the screen. I think that's what's going on there. Thank you, Dave Mason. Time to get serious for a moment here. And I do mean very serious. Recently, I lost a friend, Lance Leopard. Lance Leopard passed away, and he never really believed in the afterlife, but he certainly believed in the after party. If you go to maynard.com.au, I've written a bit of a tribute to the guy. And he's someone who should not be forgotten. And you won't forget this. In the early 80s, he was on Brisbane television, on the telethon, miming keyboard in the background on the right. So keep an eye out for Lance miming, because I don't think he could play the keyboard. Maybe he could, and he never told me. But here we are, the MegaMen in Brisbane. Check out this band. In the early 80s, more important than anything that was going on in the music was the ability to pose. And Lance Leopard could certainly do that. Love you, Lance.
Here we go. Now, this is the moment the audience have been waiting for. Right behind me, we have one of the most dynamic bands out of Brisbane for a long, long time. We got Clive, Marco and Mark, the MegaMen, with their brand new single, Designed for Living, out in 2 weeks in the stores. The MegaMen.
Took a Dietrich look, people of style, a plastic smile, the nightclub tan, we are the glam. We scream and squeal and wheel and deal. To blame. You're the
toy that gives me devotion. In the love game that I play, and when the toy gets broken, I'll simply throw it away. Where design? Design for living. For living. 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 Where design? Design for living. Not giving. Where design? Design for living. For living.
I think we're having a pretty special time here today, aren't we, boys and girls?
Yes, maybe we're not.
Yes, you are. You're having a great time, a bubble-ific time here. Look at that Aldi bubble machine go. Aldi's all No, forget I said that. Let's have a chat about the young talent team. First of all, you'll see behind me, look at this. Look at those great albums. Oh, Magpie, that is just going off. That gets better ratings than Sky News at night. It's time to find out a bit more about Magpie TV with the creator, owner, and channel CEO of Magpie TV, Rob Darby of Ballarat. Take it away, and hopefully you can show us lots and lots and lots of magpies, Rob.
Oh, brain freeze. Australia's, 100%, 1 million percent coldest, hottest, coldest 100. Come on, where are you all? There's one now. Where are the rest of you? And you, as I see you. Coldest 100 with brain freeze. With Maynard. Right, you ready? There you go. Come on, there you go. There they are. There's only two of you. Where are the other 18? Oh, yeah, now you all. Yeah, right. Now you all rock up. Yeah. Yeah, that's right. Now you all rock up. Thanks. Crazy monkey bloody things.
But young talent time. Yes, indeed. Look, what have we got here? Look at that. There's an album. This album. Oh, yeah. What if something happened to it? Well, it wouldn't really matter because I've got one here that's even better. And if you look closely, Children at Home, it's signed by just about everybody. I think Vicky missed out. But Rod and Philip signed it. There you go. So I've got the signed copy, which I treasure quite a bit. We've got ABBA, an early one, Sing Sing with Tina Arena there. Very young Tina Arena. Tiny Tina Arena, they called it. But everybody was Tiny on the show. I think that was Johnny Young's nickname as well, Tiny. Anyway, and of course that one from the early days there. Look at that. Bear bringing the funk. That's the early 70s there. But let's go to the 80s now. Let's go to the Snowfields. Let's go with Dannii Minogue, who's over there. She's on the calendar. You can play Where's Dannii? She's there on the calendar at the back. That's the only photo I can show from the calendar for reasons, you know. We have to mention our sponsors. Dolly Magazine, summer special from the summer of 86, 87. Very special. Mullets are back, as I said earlier. And so are bright colours. Very Ken Doan, isn't it, those colours? And let's have just one more photo from the fashion page again. Oh yes, look at that. Nothing says street more than horizontal striped socks. That's someone you don't want to mess with. Also our other sponsor, Australasian Post. Look at that. On the front cover in July 17th, 1958, we've got ex-sales girl, Vera Durkin, 19. She's a showgirl at Tivoli. I was a showgirl at Tivoli, you know. Show me. But it's time to go skiing with Dannii Minogue right now. Dannii on skis in the snow singing Material Girl. This is the way Madonna originally intended the song to be produced and look. Sucked in, Madonna.
know the best thing about doing Brain Freeze, Australia's Coldest 100? Thanks to Andrew Scholl. Let's have a shot of Andrew again. That's him indeed. What a guy. Every year he does the Coldest 100 in January, and we eventually get round to doing a video version of it later in the year. Apart from the bubble machine, the best thing about the Coldest 100 is we always play a Kylie track of some sort. And as you'll see behind me, look at that. And beside me, blocking the magpie bit. Sorry about that. We've got a couple of Kylie tracks there and a couple of Kylie singles at the back there and a couple of my favourites here right in front of me. Better the Devil You Know, English import. What I'd do, I would race down to Red Eye Records, get them on import and play them on my Triple J breakfast show before they were released by Mushroom in Australia. It was cool. So I could have been one of the first people to play Better the Devil You Know on the radio in Australia. I don't know. There we go. Wouldn't change a thing. Look at that. Look at those pearls swinging around. Woo-hoo! I think that might be an early Lambada Kylie's doing there. But of course, if you've got to have a good, you've got to have two of these. You don't want to be left with just one, do you? Kylie, look at that. There you go. And I've got the signed one up there. In Bed with Kylie in the special. If you go to maynard.com.au, where a lot of this music can be found and that kind of thing, you'll see the Kylie Minogue special I did for Channel V with Foxtel. We're not going to play Kylie's version right now. Wonderful woman performing with her keyboard on morning television in the UK, doing her version of I Should Be So Lucky. But what could make it better than that being danced to by our dance choreography correspondent, Leslie Fountain, Glenn Keenan. Oh, yes. Look up Glenn Keenan, look up Leslie Fountain on maynard.com.au and you'll see a 1 hour special of dancing, him demonstrating stuff in the Maynard International Studios here. It's a great show and we're going to be doing a part two sometime when we get an extension made. I Should Be So Lucky, and learn these steps at home because Leslie isn't doing this for nothing here. Dance along with Leslie Fountain, Glenn Keenan. Thanks, Glenn. Man, what a top effort. I Should Be So Lucky, 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 lucky.
Of jazz extraordinaire, Jeannie Barton. Jeannie, take it away, please.
In my imagination, there is no complication. I dream about you all the time. In my mind, a celebration, the sweetest of sensations, thinking that you could be mine. In my imagination, there is no hesitation. We walk together hand in hand. I'm dreaming. You fell in love with me, like I'm in love with you. But dreaming's all I'll do. If only they come true, I should be so lucky, 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 lucky. I should be so lucky in love. Dwee-boo-doo, I should be so lucky, 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 lucky. I should be so lucky in love. Ooh, it's a crazy situation. You always keep me waiting because it's only make-believe. And I will come a-running to give you all my loving if one day you would notice me. My heart is close to breaking and I can go on faking this fantasy that you'll be mine. I'm dreaming. You fell in love with me, like I'm in love with you. But dreaming's all I'll do, if only they'd come true. I should be so lucky, 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 lucky. I should be so lucky in love. Dwee-boo-doo, I should be so lucky, like a rubber ducky. I should be so lucky in love. One more time, yeah. I should be so lucky, 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 lucky. I should be so lucky in love. Dwee-boo-doo, I should be so lucky, 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 lucky. I should be so lucky in love.
In news from Down Under, a billionaire has called for the removal of an unflattering portrait of her from the National Gallery of Australia. The woman in question is a controversial Australian mining billionaire named Gina Rinehart, seen here. But I mean, come on, how unflattering could this portrait possibly? Okay. Okay, okay. I gotta say, I'm no art expert, but in this portrait, I believe the artist really captured her expression at the moment she saw this portrait.
I'm a coach. After a close game like that, well, of course I'm sweating.
Everybody does, dear. But you've got perspiration odour.
Well, I use a deodorant.
You need more. You need my Palmolive Gold.
Palmolive Gold's proven deodorant action helps keep you smelling good and fresh.
Well, is the game over?
Just kicking off.
Don't wait to be told. You need Palmolive Gold.
Hey, look, there's Kylie having a fight with a bear. Wow, someone her size taking on a bear. That's just amazing. Actual footage, actual bear, actual Dannii and Kylie drawing. Well, right, I hear we've got man in a tree standing by. It's currently raining at the moment. You be okay? I'm sure you will. Yeah, I'm sure you will. I can hear him in my imaginary earpiece. But before we go to him, we have to go to, he's not a professional, but talented amateur nudist, Tony Push, brings us a report from the middle of a field on a theory he's got that you may not really want to hear. Over to you, Tony Push.
Look, this is a song for, by, and with chickens. And remember one thing about chickens, it wouldn't take an obsessive conspiracy theorist to reason that chickens, yes, fowl, have trained the human race to go fetch kibble and feed the chooks. You know?
Cash Chicken, you're the only one that's a loser. Oh, except for him.
Cash Chicken!
Get into the Cash Chicken and win the opposite of big.
Cash Chicken!
Cock!
Wow, bit of chicken action there. Oh, hang on to my imaginary earpiece. Oh, yes, of course, the man in the tree is still out there in the rain.
It's raining. Can I come inside?
No. Thank you, man in the tree. Maybe you should lift your game a bit.
Hey, Charger. The unbelievable can happen to you.
Oh, yeah, just watch what the bubbles have blown in. You're watching Brain Freeze, Australia's Coldest 100, thanks to Andrew Scholl. What a guy. Look at that. Actual photo. Now, you know how we've got some sponsors for the show? As we mentioned, there's Dolly Magazine, Hats Are Back, in 86, 87. Well, they had a thing for hats. This is 1977. Look, hats are back then too. Not only hats, pogo sticks. Before the internet, all people really had was pogo sticks. Australasian, put the children away from the screen. Australasian Post, a bit racy here. This one from 1963, 3rd of January. Another showgirl putting on some lipstick. You can't even show that on TV today. Australasian Post, racy. Oh, also, TV Hits, the magazine you get when you can't find smash hits. There's that one, and oh, looky, looky, here comes Cookie. There we go. Melissa, who is next on our list in the Coldest 100? In bed with Melissa, and I've looked all the way through this, and there's not one photo of a bed. Not even a fainting couch. I think it was Lamb Week. There were people involved, and Melissa was singing it. Come on, Melissa! Woohoo!
Grab the tongue, do a twirl, give the lamb chops a whirl, dress it up, take your time, make the coals slow.
Have a bowl, butter rolls, go and heat up the coals, chill the beer, move the chairs, fold the napkins.
You can munch, you can play, 'cause today's Australia Day. Oh,
naughty Barbie, lamb chop Barbie. Oil the lamb chop, stop the Barbie. Crank the Barbie, crack the stubby.
Take that pork off your fork, have some lamb if you please. Try a rack or a chop off the plate on your knees.
Come jump in, be my mate, as the chops marinate. Let's cool down, splash around, wet the budgies.
You can touch.
Mummy, you look money. Come and bust a move and let's get yummy. Be a smarty, grab a charty. If you're feeling nippy, grab yourself a cardy. It's foolhardy to be tardy to the party. And the roast is looking fly. Just don't get all up in my grill. I'm a Barbie bloke. Where's me rum and coke? Apron's plastic. It's fantastic. With the bold up chick and dick cream everywhere. It's my vocation. It's Barbie for the nation. It's un-Australian to eat anything else on Australia Day.
You know, it makes sense.
I'm Sam Kekovich.
I'm Melissa, a national treasure. Oh, quick quiz here. Haven't asked many questions today, but how about this one? If you had a cup from the 70s and it had the inscription, get with the strength, written on the side of it, get with the strength, what bank would your money be with? Yes, way before there was a banking inquiry, the answer is the Commonwealth Bank. I've got one of the cups here. I don't drink from it. The interest is too high. But there we go. Get with the strength. My orange cup, which is probably not booper or pooper or duper, certainly not pooper free, that's for sure. But right now, I'm just going to reach over here. Don't look at my Batman shorts. Whatever you do, have none of that. That's right. Because I'm doing this myself, I'm completely off camera now. So I can just go, yeah. I'm pulling faces at you like you wouldn't believe. And I'm going to show you this. I'll just let you all calm down and try and work out what it is. It is, in fact, a Jimmy Barnes alarm clock. Valued at as much as $17. Sure, Maynard. An alarm clock tells the time. Got a great photo of Jimmy on the front there. But is it any good as an alarm clock? Well, I'll put it here among my copious notes I've made. So you're sleeping, and then in case you missed it, fist me dead, that's loud. And that's the Jimmy Barnes alarm clock. You could wake up to that noise. Clears your sinuses as well. That's right. Jimmy Barnes alarm clock available from Jimmy Barnes's website. That's mine. On days when I really don't want to get up, this gets you out of bed, particularly if you put it across the room. Rings for 45 minutes like that if you don't stop it. But by then, I think the police have been called. There's Jimmy Barnes. Someone's being murdered upstairs. You be quiet, okay? We won't have any more of that behaviour out of you just now, because we've got to talk about your arch rival, John Farnham. Johnny Farnham. Mr. Farnham, You're the Voice would perhaps be his greatest. Well, no, hang on. No. There is one song better than You're the Voice, and I think you all know what it is. It's been on the Coldest 100 before. And one thing we don't do on the Coldest 100 is play stuff we've played before. Except when it's Johnny Farnham doing an ad for the Rundle Mall. I mean, we've got to do something for the people of Adelaide. They came second to Tasmania in the What the Hell Do You Do competition. Go, Johnny!
Rundle Mall starts to come alive before the morning sun has reached the sky. While you're still at home in your cozy bed, we're busy getting ready for the day ahead. Rundle Mall, it's the biggest variety show in town. We'll make you look like a star, and wherever you are, there's always specials to be found. The place to be, it's the biggest show in town.
I don't know about you, but I've come over all emotional after that. Those flowers, that friendly service, that dancing, that singing, that getting up early. There's only one thing that can cure her of this, and that is Cilla Black. Being a bit puzzled on the back. Cilla Black. See, hats weren't in then. I thought Jimmy was going to go off there for a moment. I almost pooped myself. She did You're the Voice. Now, Andrew Scholl found this. It was on a show about a castle and a guy. It's probably best I don't explain it because it doesn't really make a lot of sense. Cilla Black, You're the Voice. Now sing along with me. I'm the voice, I'm wearing underpants now around my neck. Na 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 na. Yeah, sing along at home, people. Don't get me involved with this. It's a Cilla Black thing, okay?
Chance to turn the pages over. We can write what we want to write. We gotta make ends meet before we get much older.
Underpants, yeah. Oh, what a top song, and what a great version from Cilla Black and her pipes, indeed. Hang on a minute. Shh, be quiet down there, Aldi bubble machine. Got a few questions have been asked to me of people on the website there, in the chat room there. Lorna, will you be playing any slimy things? Slimy things, Australia's only sci-fi variety comedy band. Well, yes, okay, let's have a quick one from Slimy Things, from their album Made for Robots by Robots.
It's made by robots. Robots.
Slimy Things. Probably can't find that anywhere. Oh, look, mighty Australian nightclub, Hellfire Club. If you haven't been there, too late, closed. Oh, How many executive albums have you got, Maynard? Let's have a look over here. Hang on a minute. The executives. Let's have a look. As you know, their 60s album. And never mind don't look at my lead. Don't look at my lead. How many? Well, count them with me. 1, 2 executive albums. 3 executive albums. 4 executive albums. 5 executive albums. And you can probably get them cheaper than you can get a Jimmy Barnes alarm clock. Right now, there's an emergency in Australia. Lots of things are wrong. Just have a look around. Just have a look around here. Just have a look around here. Lots of things are wrong. And when things are wrong, you have to call for Peter Allen. But if you can't get Peter Allen, go to my Patreon, Peter Young at Orange. Whenever there's something going on, call Pete. He'll fix you up. We need a bit of Peter Allen. We need a bit of Peter Allen in our life. We need some Peter Allen in our life. Hey Pete, I need you to introduce I Go to Rio again this year. We need you to summon your inner Peter Allen. Come on Pete, you can do it. Give us some Peter Allen.
Why do I still have my normal shoes on?
Maynard, it's all your fault.
When my baby, when my baby spies me at the Rio de Janeiro, I'm the lady. When my baby spies me, the sun lights up my life, and I am free at last. What a blast!
Thank you, Donnie. Thank you, Marie. If you need any Peter Allen anywhere near you, you could go no further than to look to Donnie and Marie or Peter Young from Orange, one of my Patreons. Why don't you become a patron of the whole thing? Support whatever this is. Planet Maynard, go there. There's a Patreon link at the bottom. Become a Patreon and get special things sent to you. Some of them you might even want. No Skippy on the show, but at least we showed the cover, because right now, time check in with the Countdown Dancers from 1979 now. Now, a lot of people say, Countdown Dancers, not as good as Pants People, not as good as Legs & Co. I say nay, I say, because I like to sound like a horse sometimes. I say nay, because they had a fraction of the budget and they had to do what they could with bits of alfoil and everything like that. This is a classic one. And look, just to compare them for a moment, let's compare them a moment to Legs & Co. Let's have a look at just a few seconds of this. Remember, the BBC has an enormous budget. See what they do with exactly the same song. Let's have a little bit of a look at this. I think Tanya Lacey and the Countdown Dancers did very well there. Won't hear a word against them. So let's go out with this. This will rock your socks off, people. Thank you to all the guests that have been on the show. Thank you to all the people that have helped. Thanks to Rob. Thanks to Bridget. Thanks to Tim. Thanks to Leslie Fountain, Glenn Keenan. Thanks to Pete Young. Thanks to the man in the trees, probably still out there in the rain. No, you can't come in. And a whole bunch of other people that made this possible, except today I've done it all on myself, so really I've only got myself to blame. And if you've been watching it, you've really only got yourself to blame. But the best thing you can say about Brain Freeze, Australia's Coldest 100, 2024, is that it's over. So come on, bring the countdown dancers in. We'll just see you out with some Jimmy. Shit.
Maynard.com.au